In the currency quadrant today, the euro is actually down 1% on the lows, rallied back a little bit, but the euro is actually up slightly and then collapsed after the FOMC here in the U.S. cut rates by 25 basis points and ended their quantitative tightening a month earlier than scheduled. Now, a lot of that was what the whole day was overshadowed by. We had some data in the ECB this morning. The data wasn't that bad. GDP was in line. The jobs data for the eurozone was in line. The German retail sales was actually better than expected. But the eurozone price data missed. The CPI data in the eurozone was weak. And that's really what all this is about, is global inflation falling, is growth falling. And the ECB is now viewed that they'll be the most dovish central bank out there, at least in the short term, now that the Fed rate hike is out of the way. We had a BOJ meeting this week. They did nothing. We had the Bank of England meeting this week. They did nothing. The Fed has now cut rates. And last week, the ECB had their meeting, and they did nothing but implied that they would probably be a little bit more dovish than they had been. And it looks like the perception, at least by the price action we saw in the euro today, is that they're going to be piling on to everything else. So the ECB is now at least on deck for their rate cut, and the euro is suffering. That's what got the euro down into the 110 handle today.